This is the wheel and hub on my 1982 GMC 1-ton. This is a Dana 60 axle. And I couldn't really find any awesome videos on YouTube showing how the hubs come apart. So I'm gonna show you. When you get inside, there are nuts, hub nuts in there that you need a special socket for. This is one that I bought. It's made by Lyle. They seem to make good sockets. There are a couple of different styles, so you need to check it out before you get into your project real deep. I'll show you how you can check it before you have to lift the vehicle off the ground. This particular socket is 2990. Bought it from Rock Auto. They do have several other models, so make sure you get the right one. Okay, I do want to tell you guys, I'm not a professional mechanic. This is actually the first time I've gotten into a Dana 60 hub, so make sure you do your research. There are several different kinds of Dana 60s, so this is just a general guideline. Turn the locking hub to free, and then these six Allen head cap screws come out. It's a 9/64 Allen wrench. On each side, I had a broken Allen screw. You can get replacements from Home Depot. I was not able to find them at Lowe's, but it's a 8/32 by 1.5 stainless steel. Anyway, so you take out the six and the hub cap just pulls off, and that's what's inside. Okay, once you got the cap off, you need to take this Phillips head screw out. That just retains the center cog. This has a spring behind it, so don't let it fly out on you. Once you pull the center cog out, you need to take this snap ring, this internal snap ring, out. Just pulls out like that. Watch your eyes, wear eye protection. Next, you need to take out this big snap ring that goes around the whole circumference here. It holds this center part in. It's difficult to get out. Just use some flathead screwdrivers. It's a little bit frustrating. It will come out. Starting to get the end out here. It's difficult. What I do is pry this first tip in towards the center, and then pry the inside of the ring up. It's not easy. Once you get it started, just kind of gradually go around the outside and gently pry the inside edge out. You don't want to bend this up.
And there it is, finally. Got to be patient with this. That took about 5 or 10 minutes just to get that out. So anyway, that ring comes out. And then the center section should come out. Easier way to pull it out is to take one of the locking hub screws, thread it into its original hole, and then you can wiggle it out. Everything that we've done up till now, you can do with the truck on the ground. You don't need to remove the wheel and tire. I took one of these apart a few weeks ago to figure out what hub socket I needed. This is the axle. The spindle is right around it, and then you can see the locking nuts around that. My particular axle has the four notches on the locking nuts. That's where this huge socket comes in. Fits in there. So there are other sockets and nut styles. I believe there's a six notch one, so you might want to disassemble this just to this point to see what socket you need before you dig real deep into the project. This is the back side of the caliper. This is the bottom. Here's the hub out here. We need to remove this Allen head bolt so that we can get the caliper off. After you get that out, you can tap this plate out. This plate will slide out that way. So this is the piece that came out of here. This is a spring that sits on top and it slides between here. We pounded it out this way with a hammer and chisel. And that will allow the caliper to come off. Back on the front side, since we took the plate and spring out from down here, we can get the caliper off. And make sure you, here's some brake pads, make sure you wire it up so it doesn't put a lot of tension on the brake line. You don't want that. So I'm just gonna hang it here from the shock mount. Now it's off. You got a little more access to the hub and brake disc now. Now that we've got the brake caliper off, we can work on getting the spindle nuts off. You gotta take your big socket and fit it in the grooves in the nut, and I've already loosened these, but they basically just screw off. Well, the outer one is in there. Now you've got a locking washer with all these holes in it. It's difficult to see, but right up in here, there's a pin. It's a tiny, tiny pin that sticks through that locking washer and into the back nut. And that keeps that back nut from moving. I'll take the washer out here. You can see all the little holes. There's a little tang here on the inside, and that fits in this groove and the spindle so that this lock nut can't move. Now there's a little pin right there. It's kind of fragile. Just make sure you don't shear that off. Again, you take your socket, make sure it fits in the grooves in the nut, and just back it off. when you get the internet off, you can see the little pin sticking out. Sticking out right here. So now that we've got both sets of nuts out, we should be able to pull the hub off. The disc will come with it, so it's probably a little bit heavy. There you go. It is a little bit heavy, so just be careful. You don't want to scratch up the spindle or the drive shaft, so be careful with that. Here's another shot of the spindle after the hub and disc have been removed. You can see again, this is the slot that the locking washer fits in, and just the surfaces that the seals ride on, make sure they're all good. These nuts here should allow you to pull the spindle off. I believe there's another bearing inside the spindle that the drive shaft rides on. Here are all the parts again that we took off, laid out. I got the other side started. Here's the hub and the brake disc that we just took off. You can see inside there's a bearing on the front side, and there's also one on the back side. I haven't taken them out yet to inspect. If you're doing a brake job, you need to separate the hub from the disc by pressing these studs out down through the hub and the disc. That's how they're held together. Here's the back side of the hub and disc. You can see there's the backside bearing and also a seal right on the outside edge here. And these are the wheel studs that have to be pressed through in order to separate the two halves.